Yeah. Guru. The Roots. Yeah. Come on, y'all. Lift your fist. Yeah, lift your fist. Come on.
To all my people, just lift your fist.
We back again.
Seem like it ain't no peace, no justice.
This is gonna be a quick post. I really hope that I can get this done. I have so much to show you guys what I did this weekend. Now, I'm working on limited funds. Y'all know I'm getting my house done. But this weekend, on Friday, I was driving home and I noticed that I stopped by Salvation Army. And when I went in there, the Salvation Army is just there on some other stuff right now. I mean, they had Firm Planet in their ass when it comes to albums in this area, because literally they are sending not even a crate's worth of albums at a store at a time, and then they rotate them. So went in there and it was just so many albums. I've never seen this many albums in the Salvation Army, so I'm digging through them. There's crates. There's at least 8 to 9 crates of albums. Well, you know, easily that's like 300 to 400, maybe 500 records, when normally there's only like 30 records. And so I started noticing that all of them came from the same collection. I started seeing the same names on them. I started seeing this guy, what he did is he took out cartoons from the funny pages and he put them on the records. So I was like, man, this is a concentrated collection. And it was all golden age and classic hip hop. I'm starting to see some lag in my video. What's that sound? Behind the violent attacks, behind the deadly gunplay, the cocaine and the crack. I had to edit this. What's the reason for the treason? Everybody's got it. Some gotta resort to thieving. Take money, make money. So all my people just lift your fists. Let's do this. Bear with me, guys. That's better, right? So, like I was saying, I know how the Salvation Army does here, because remember, if you think back to my earlier videos, I know the guy who mentors the Salvation Army guys here in D.C., and I've been able to go into their warehouse or distribution center and get albums. It's not an easy thing to pull off, but I have been able to do it. And so I know when they get albums and they split it up and they send it to stores all over the region. So I was pulling out this great hip-hop, and I said, you know what, tomorrow I gotta hit up every store in the region. And that's what I did. I went to 6 different stores, and as I was going into the stores, lo and behold, boom, crates and crates of records. And I started looking at them, the cartoons were there, the names were there, I was on a roll. And like literally whole catalogs of hip-hop artists. So you would see like a stack, and then it'd be Ice Cube's complete catalog. Wow, that was a lot of lag. Yeah, it'll be his complete catalog. Take off the autofocus. Boom. Maybe that seems better, right? This is totally messing up my video. But anyway, yeah, so I went to all the stores and I started noticing that it was all from the same thing. So I spent the whole weekend, I went to all the stores in the region, and I was able to make away with this. Now, I literally went through about 3,000 albums, and that's what I'd left. I could have gone with more. I was seeing like Ice Cube's full catalog, stuff like that, but I just don't have the money. I could easily have bought 300, easily purchased 300 records, but no, I kept it simple. I went for what I knew was rare. I went for stuff that I knew was rare, that I knew I wasn't gonna see again, and that I was seeing for the first time. So let me just start. First joint that I snagged that I didn't have is boom. Check it out, hip hop fans. Helter Skelter, Nocturnal. It's a double LP. Definitely out of print. Look at that. Y'all hip hop heads, y'all know about Helter Skelter. This is some dumb, real serious hip hop, y'all. And that album is not easy to find. Believe me, it's like this. It's like most of the stuff is like that little knick-knack stuff that you want as a hip hop collector, but you just don't want to put your money towards because it just chip away, and it's just like, you know, you don't necessarily want to listen to it all the time, but you want to have it in your collection. Second one is Bobby Digital. Digital Bullet. Bobby. Digi. All up in your ass like a Victoria's Secret wedgie. Yeah. The RZA, y'all. And then I showed this album before. This is Kool Keith. Dr. Octagon. Or Dr. Octagonicologist. Double LP. On Bulk Records. This is a heavy hitter, y'all. This is definitely highly collectible. This is not hard to find, but you know, the album's all over the place as far as price. For the most part, it's like $40, but I've seen it go all the way to 90, and I've seen it go for as little as 12, and the person was claiming it was mint. So who knows? But it's just good to snag something like that because it is good music. Here's a Dr. Octagonicologist that I didn't have, the Ultramagnetic Time Machine. I didn't have this, No Awareness, Bear Witness, Earth People. This was awesome, man. I couldn't believe I found this. And check out Kool Keith. Side one, side A. You know, keeping in that true hip-hop fashion, you know? Hip-hop heads, alert. Check it out, y'all. If you're not collecting hip hop, you're probably not gonna understand this. But if you ever find anything produced by J Dilla, it's a relic, okay? Anything J Dilla. You can have 15 copies of the same album. If it's a Dilla album, it's the shit. What is more? So I don't even need to talk about that. And so, oh, check this out, y'all. Remember a couple weeks ago that I said about the Big Daddy Kane? On Prism Records? Big Daddy Kane and Biz Markie recorded on Prism Records, and it was never easy to find. Man, look at this lag that I'm having in this. This is driving me crazy. Let me try to... Hello. So, I just switched it up, and I think that the lighting was causing lag. I don't know. It seems to be okay now, but like I was saying, Big Daddy Kane record on Prism is not easy to find, and I was finding one for the first time a couple of weeks ago. And now, not only have I found it again, the same one, but I found the white label promo, Word to the Mother. Hold on. And see, you know, I had to take the autofocus off because, man, it's just, everything's bugging today. I can't get my camera to work, but I'm trying to put on the autofocus. And if it's not working, I'll take it back off. But this is Big Daddy Kane's white label promo on Prism Records, Word to the Mother. And here's one that I've been chasing forever. And I'm almost there. I'm not quite there yet. But look how beat up that is. The vinyl is beautiful, though. This is on Cold Chillin' Records. This is Ain't No Half Steppin' 12-inch. Ain't No Half Steppin'. Y'all know about that, right? Wow, I don't want to focus? I'm having a horrible time with this, with my camera. But anyway, this is actually what's had me start driving around the region, because I started seeing that he was all having stuff like this. But I mean, you know, the don't get no better than this, man. Okay. Next one. Check this out. This is Sealed. This is Common, as in Common Sense. The Bitch in You. And this is actually from 95, 96, and this is when he had his beef with Ice Cube, and this was, you know, one of the early golden era hip-hop beefs between Common and Ice Cube, a straight-up Midwest, West Coast beef. And this is sealed, y'all. Check that out, teacher. Dope as hell, huh? So you guys kind of start seeing what I mean when I say that there was some real cool stuff. And he had all Cool Keith, and then he had all of the Ultramagnetic conceivers. And I have a lot of the Ultramagnetic conceivers, except for one of their most collectible 12-inches, Papa Large. And now I have it. And as you see, that's the little cartoon character I was talking about that he put on most of his stuff. And the jacket is beat up. Look at that. Ultramagnetic NCs, y'all. Whew. But even though the jacket's beat up, the vinyl is beautiful. Real beautiful. I'm wondering if, I mean, I don't see any DJ markers on here. I'm just wondering if he was just a straight up collector. Every hip hop head goes crazy when he sees a Lord Finesse. Lord Finesse, man, not only is it dumb money, for some reason, and I could be wrong now, because it's been a few years since I've checked, I don't think they've reissued this stuff. I just think it's all straight up out of print. I could be wrong. I mean, I really could be, but, you know, I knew once upon a time, like, none of his stuff was reissued, and I know that this is definitely not a reissue. I can tell by how damn beat up it is. But like I said, man, I got the vinyl, so it's cool. This next one, as far as value, is not a holy grail. Holy grail is normally really valuable. But I think I said it before, this is one of the stepping stones to the holy grail for 12-inch hip-hop LPs. Anything by these dudes, let me tell you, because... I mean, the value is up there too, don't get me wrong. But anything from Sho and AG, you know now. And this is the white label promo. This was one of the heavy hitters of the weekend that I found. This is that straight up dope ass hip hop. There's the lag again. I don't know what's going on, man, but let me see. It's just dope hip hop, man. And no, what more can I say? I would do a needle drop, but I'm just gonna keep it moving. Y'all, I just had to edit again, but I'm gonna keep it moving because, you know, if I have to stop it after every damn record that it zooms in on because of the lag, then I will. But this next joint is considered random rap. This is out of my area here in DC. This is on Vestry Records, and this is The Constant Deviants. But anyway, out of Baltimore, dope, what they call in the hip-hop collecting part of record collecting, they call this random rap. I think they call it random rap because it's not on a major label. I don't really know what defines random rap. Only thing that I could tell is just it's always on like an independent or excuse me, private label. But anyway, some more random rap out from this my area. I think this is also out of Baltimore. This is Norm Scala. This is rare, y'all. Real rare. And rap is just now starting to be respected and explored right now as far as, you know, all that's out there. So as people are discovering them, they're doing their research, they're asking people how many, they're contacting the record companies, or at least the people who were involved in back in the day, and they're doing their homework and finding out the number of presses, and that eventually is going to drive the price of these things. But these two are already up there in price as far as collecting random rap. And then here's another one, and this is sealed. This is APB. Some more random rap out of this area. Black Cloud, APB, Black Cloud. It's another random rap, and this is sealed. This is sealed, and this is not easy to find either. This is definitely gonna be sold if you have it. You slap it up there on eBay. It's gonna be bids on it, for real. People want it. Then I got some two not so known random raps. M/Billet. in good times. So I don't know about these. I mean, I know about this one, T-Rex low-key. Not terribly quality rap, so I mean, it's not that collectible. And that's it for as far as what I got from the store, but I was going to share something else, but I'm going to save it for next time. Once I complete the catalog, which should be in a couple of weeks, then I'll show that. That's it. That's all I have. Yeah.